с вами начали заниматься такой трудной темой, о которой сейчас только и знают, что говорят. Я уже сообщал вам, что 10-й Всемирный Русский Народный Собор...
We've started to consider such a difficult problem that stands high in people's discussions. I've informed you that the 10th World Russian People's Council is devoted to this very problem, problem of freedom and human rights.
Когда парламентская ассамблея Совета Европы постановила о том, что религиозные...
Parliamentary Assembly of the Council of Europe declared that religious rights are subordinate to human rights. Do you realize how serious this fact is and what it could result in? Women can demand holy orders, otherwise they might call it infringement on their rights. The so-called minorities will demand church recognition, and not only a public recognition. The church that would not agree to it will find itself to be out of law, as was the case in ancient Rome. Christianity was the religio illicita, illegal religion. And now, if the church that doesn't recognize it as the proper order of things, as a norm of human life, and will condemn it, will find itself outlawed. So the process is going on in one direction, and it is quite obvious. It is going along the route, maybe not in form, as the essence lies not in the form, but in its ideological contents, that has been tied up long with masonry fundamentals.
Необходимо проводить в жизнь следующий принцип: разнуздать, чтобы взнуздать.
Underlying the principle to unbridle in order to bridle. That principle is strikingly strong, and it is being enforced into life with strong determination and sequence of so-called enlightened society, that is, European and American ones. And now it will be carried out in this country as there are no more ideological boundaries. So I have already told you, if we consider freedom and human rights idealistically, that will sound fine and clear-cut, to give freedom to every person. But on the other hand, realize as any right is two-sided, it can be used as anyone might wish to. In the same way, freedom, one would do what he wants. For one, freedom of speech, it may be used as being able to publish not only obscene words, but long, unquotable speeches, insulting, lewd, that is evident. Secondly, what should be borne in mind, if we understand this freedom, irrespective of a particular person, what all that could result in?
Так, и можно ли, сразу возникает вопрос, дать...
Every person is in a certain moral, spiritual condition. The question arises immediately. Could the same equal rights be given both to a highly morally motivated and law-obedient man and to a criminal? Just please try and give the same freedoms which are granted to the law-obedient people and to the criminal society. What would come out of any society, any state? These are the two things that strike the eye when we hear all this noise and these cries about freedoms and freedoms and freedoms.
И, наконец, последнее, что нужно сказать, что все те юридические свободы, которые даются законом, так они...
And finally, они legal freedoms, делают, which are given by law. The most possible thing they could do is to detain from the most vicious crimes, damaging human bodies, basically.
Только, в основном касающихся телесной жизни человека. тело его. Вот. Только здесь свободы устанавливают некие ограничения.
In this case, only freedoms impose some limits. But the most important and significant things lie in the fact that legal freedoms do not contain the major thing from the Christian point of view. They do not target human being at spiritual freedom, at acquisition of spiritual freedom. They do not do anything in this aspect. Do you remember we talked about three types of freedom? All these outward rights and freedoms do not direct, do not stimulate, do not call for spiritual freedom. In other words, they imply I might act in whichever way I want to, though it will affect detrimentally the other people.
Вот одна из, я хотел сказать, ошибок, на самом деле...
So I would like to say that one of the mistakes, or rather one of the insidious things that are hidden in that propaganda of freedom, lie in the fact that when they speak about prohibitions, they refer really to the life of a body only. Spiritual and moral aspects are not taken into account. Just realize what is behind it. Make it a point. In front of these facts, a man is considered to be not more than an animal. The concern is only about a body, about its rights, tied up with biological intelligence, aesthetic needs, that is to say, about purely materially based interests and nothing else. It is saturated with materialism, with deepest materialism and atheism. God is not mentioned at all. They do not mean the spiritual side of a human being, not in the least. Suffice is to look at those moral perversions which are being advocated, or at some things which should be hidden from open public being naturally, in order to understand and to make sure of that. Spiritual side of a man, that is what makes a man a human being, and that is the only thing that makes him a human being in its essence, is not taken into account. And I would say it is simply ignored. A man is considered almost as an animal. Here where the root lies, here where the main trouble is, that is enclosed in that very subject matter, in the way it is being viewed by the modern world.
Подвержено влиянию греха и страстей, видите, говорит о духовной стороне человека.
I cited the quotation from Saint Ignatius of Antioch, who evaluated the possibility of achieving these freedoms. He writes, as long as the mankind is subordinate to the influence of a thing or passions, you see that he speaks about a spiritual side of a man. Power and subordination are needed. They are sure to exist as long as the world lives, but they may appear now and will appear in different forms. And then he says, neither equality, nor perfect freedoms, nor prosperity on the earth can exist on earth in that very measure as they wish to. And what is being promised by excited false teachers? Relationship between power and subordination will be destroyed only when the world is destroyed. Then authority and power will come to an end. Then brotherhood, equality and freedom will be established. Do you remember the main motto of the French Revolution, brotherhood, equality, freedom? How easily people can be allured by these empty words, which mean, in fact, quite the opposite. Then the reason for the power and subordination unity will be love, not fear. You see how from the above said we can understand What is the principal position of Christianity relative to the rights and freedoms? How can these rights and freedoms be considered as some external conditions only that must help a man not only to preserve his or her humanity, but as far as it is possible to elevate this humanity? As soon as freedoms act into their opposite, they become evil, not good. In moral aspect, we'll all become witnesses of these things. What basic principle should be laid in functioning or fulfilling these rights and freedoms that the world speaks about? We Christians do not deny the right of a person of freedom of speech, freedom of press, freedom of belief. We do not deny, not in the least. These are natural things, like it is natural for a person to be hungry, to be thirsty, and etc. But what should be laid in the foundation of these rights? As all human rights concern not a single person, but the whole society, because we all live in a society, not in a forest. We all influence each other. We can influence anyway. And we influence not only externally when we are in contact with each other, but spiritually. We influence spiritually because spiritual influence, this is the reality, and we cannot depart from it. We know that in each society, state, family, even in each book, there is its spirit and spiritual influence, to say nothing about the moral one, which is quite obvious. So spiritual influence is always present. That is why it is very important to see what lies in the root, in the very basis of these rights and freedoms, which are we're speaking about. What is the main thing here? I believe what is the most important here, my friends, is to emphasize one notion that should be borne in mind, and I would like to draw your attention to that. What do you think should be the major principle in all our inter-humankind relations, and in that very problem of freedom and human rights? Fear of love. What is fear of love? You know, doctors take the oath of Hippocrates, do not do any harm, fear not to harm. What is the fear of that? Fear of love towards a person. A doctor should make everything possible to cure a person. True, save him from death, not to make him get the infection. It is a fear to do a person a lot of harm. On the contrary, we are to save him as far as we can from the real and possible harm. Fear of love. Here is the basic principle of Christian understanding of what rights and freedoms mean. Fear of love, that is the main thing, not to harm. Even the venerable Versinophius the Great said, good is the freedom tied up with fear of God. What is the fear of God? What is the fear of God? We often speak about that. That is not a fair affront of God as before a monster that can swallow if you did anything wrong. Nothing of the kind. God is love, invariable love. That is the fear to insult God loves, and we should not understand it like God perhaps loves me somehow and I'm afraid to insult him. Not that. God is inside a man. Kingdom of God is within us, tells us the gospel. God is and is called the nature of all that exists and our nature as well. Not in essence, but in its energy. This thought belongs to Gregory Palama. So when we speak about a fear of love, we mean how not to do harm by our behavior, by our freedom. Do you hear? By our freedom, by our rights. Fear is a very good word when we have the fear of insulting a dearest beloved man. We are afraid to insult the person who saved our life, maybe saved you from great sufferings and misfortunes. So constantly helps us in our life. We are afraid to insult because of love and gratitude to him. So it turns out that the basic principle of Christian life lies in love. And here, when we speak about behavioral side of a man and rights and freedoms are behavioral side of a human being, here the basic principle should be the fear of love. Unfortunately, this humanitarian morale does not know it at all. This is a real evil. A man is God the man. Look what a great motto that seems to be. But in real fact, I am God. Egocentrism is striking. Pride meets pride, measuring themselves. Who is most pride? Do not touch me, and I will not touch you. And you touch me, then you will know. Here is what the competition occurs. So you see, the Venerable Radonezh said, good is the freedom connected with the fear of God. If freedom is not connected with the fear of God, so you may say, right away, my friends, it becomes murderous for a man and a society. It results in the most negative consequences, most negative and in moral degradation above all. I am free and I behave how I want to, and we see it practically everywhere. I notice it everywhere. One lady called me yesterday and said, my husband and wife went to Romania. We thought to have a vacation for 2 weeks. These are Christians. So we couldn't stay on the beach, just could not. We could not watch what was going on there.